3 weeks until the primary, voter registration deadline today. On February 12th, members of the GOP will choose a victor in the contentious battle brewing for the 1st District Congressional seat. Will the incumbent be unseated? Republican State Senator Andy Harris certainly hopes so. 11 News reporter Kate Amara has more in tonight's Commitment 2008 report. Andy Harris is a state senator, a commander in the Naval Reserves, and a doctor and professor at Johns Hopkins Hospital. He has also become a political candidate, throwing his hat in the ring in the Republican primary for the 1st District Congressional seat. So our big question when we sat down with the 50-year-old to talk about his primary run, when does he have time to sleep? It's crab soup for lunch at the Harris House, and a chance for three-term state senator Andy Harris to log some QT with the family before heading to Annapolis.
I'm going to leave right from Annapolis to go to the studio.
Lawmaker is just one of many hats worn by this Brooklyn-born father of five. Harris is a Republican primary candidate for the 1st District Congressional seat, as well as a commander in the Naval Reserves and a doctor at Johns Hopkins.
As I tell people, once you've done an internship, there's nothing more difficult than you can ever do in your entire life. So I learned time management very early on.
In his bid to unseat the incumbent, the Harris campaign has been racking up endorsements from the GOP, including former Governor Bob Ehrlich, drawn to Harris's record as a fiscal and social conservative. The senator says those values were shaped by his strong Christian faith and his background. Harris is a first-generation American. His parents fled communism. His father spent a year and a half in a concentration camp.
You know, I understand how that the world is not always a nice place. There is evil in the world. He spent a year and a half in a Russian prison camp in Siberia. He knew firsthand when you have totalitarians, what happens when you don't have democracy. You know what the result is, and it makes my resolve even stronger to say that, you know, America must prevail against the Islamic terrorists.
And so Harris is determined to cast votes on Capitol Hill for the war on terror and the pro-life movement, against illegal immigration and gay marriage, and he's willing and able to give up some sleep in order to get there.
I've worked hard for things I care about my entire life, and this is no exception. And I'm hoping that when people look at the candidates, and again, I hope they take a good look at the candidates and their records, I think that they will appreciate that in this conservative district that a conservative would serve them well in Congress, and I hope to be that one.
The primary is February 12th. In the meantime, if you'd like to learn more about any of the candidates, you can head to our website, WBALTV.com, and click on politics. Tomorrow night, we continue our candidate profile series with another Republican challenger in the primary race, State Senator E.J. Pipkin. In the Update Center, I'm Kate Amara, WBAL-TV 11 News.